Mary Godwin, and D's Jindal channel. Don't forget, follow along on YouTube. Subscribe.
Don't forget, follow along on YouTube. Subscribe, like, and share in the poop alert button. So you know which one all day long. Follow us on Instagram, and please like and follow us on Facebook. You can get all sorts of cool content and
folks. Cheers, guys.
Cheers, guys. Hi, everybody, and welcome to our virtual happy hour here at MD's Jindal channel. Happy Monday, and it is truly in the season. It is time. Season is right here upon us. So let me know what you're drinking. Let me know what's going on. How was your holiday? What did you do? It's also Hanukkah, so happy Hanukkah to everybody. And without further ado, let's bring in Miss Judy Gannon, see what's going on with her. Hi, Judy.
Oh.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you fine.
There you are. How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
Ooh, you know.
Good holiday weekend?
It was a long weekend. How about you?
It was wonderful, but yes, it was long.
It is, you know, I just said it, we are in season right now. It is here. It's here.
It's here.
So I suggest everybody goes out and get some Alka-Seltzer and keeps it in their medicine cabinet. Or ginger ale or bitters or whatever we're talking about here, because I am full to the brim with food and drink.
Oh, yeah, all those leftovers.
Did you have a good Thanksgiving?
I had a great Thanksgiving.
Well,
how was your Thanksgiving?
Oh, God. Oh, it was awesome. It was really, really good. It was easy. I didn't have to do much cooking at all. I just post-Thanksgiving, so it was fine.
Good, good.
But it started Wednesday night where you guys, Judy and I, were hanging out, having a couple holiday cocktails. And we did a tasting. You were there Wednesday, weren't you?
I did not make it Wednesday.
Oh, geez. Why did I think you were there?
I was there in spirit.
That's all that matters. Sorry about that. So Wednesday we started with a Two Trees whiskey sampling. We did that at one of my stores called Bogies and Stogies in Port St. Lucie, Florida. And we had Southern Eagle come in and they did tastings and everybody got to sample the salted caramel, the green apple, the peach, everything. So everyone got to really, you know, start out their holiday with a bang with a couple complimentary pops, you know.
Nice, very nice.
So that was fun. I think I have a picture here. We didn't, I don't know if we put it up yet or not, of our people. So that was really, really fun. And, oh, hi, Rip. How are you up there in the freezing cold bird?
Ooh, yeah.
Your Wednesday was wild? Yeah, ours too. So we started with a whiskey tasting, and that was fun. And then it was Thanksgiving Day.
Yeah. Which,
you know, there's our picture. That's some nice patrons tasting, and our Southern Eagle rep, Mr. Mike Weiss, who was so nice enough to come out on the night before Thanksgiving and give us some free samples.
Southern Eagle, you guys are the best.
Yep, so that was fun. And then, obviously, Thursday, we all ate till we couldn't move. I had the most beautiful 27-pound turkey in the world that came out of my oven.
Nice!
And we're still eating it. There's a picture of that bird. I am telling you, ooh, it was good.
And nice.
Then we had Friday, so that was Black Friday.
Yep.
Everybody went crazy with their shopping. I didn't do any shopping, did you?
I did not do any crazy shopping.
Me neither. It's only 26 days till Christmas, you know.
Yes, I know.
And I see the back, your background, your Hallmark background.
I did. I spent Friday decorating and taking Thanksgiving down and putting Christmas up.
It's so quick, you know, it's just so quick.
Yes.
So then you guys, we did this crazy thing where we went right in our own backyard here in Port St. Lucie, Florida, where there is a Club Med, and it's the very last United States property of any Club Med. So we were nice enough, they invited us over, we went over, and look at these beautiful pictures of this club. Is an all-inclusive club located right on the St. Lucie River. And you know what's really cool? I just found this out. On that same river, they filmed portions of Moonraker, the James Bond movie with Roger Moore.
Oh, okay.
Did you know that?
I did not.
There's a famous boat chase where he's got that, there's a picture of it. It's that old 70-something glass truck flying over another boat. That's right where we were on Saturday.
Nice.
Yeah. So this is the really pretty room that they have for you. It was nice. And there's also some other really good pictures, but it's all inclusive. So you can buy, you know, you can go for a week, you can go for a day. We stayed overnight. I know you guys left a little early.
Mm-hmm.
But it's all you can drink, all you can eat. Oh, there's Judy and I with the sunset.
So much fun.
How cute we looked. Oh, and we went paddleboarding and kayaking, which was fun. It was all included in your price. So that was really cool. And you know, it's right in your backyard. So why not go for it?
Yeah, give it a shot if you haven't been. It's a lot of fun.
And at night, they got like a whole party disco thing going on where people dress up. Here's me and one of my girls that showed up at night. And we almost looked like twins there.
Nice. So much fun.
We got dressed up and it was a little chilly, you know, for us here in Florida. But we had such a great time and they did a good job. They really did. That's the nightclub where they did all the different songs. And oh, there's our cameraman with his hands full. And that's right in the beginning with our very first cocktail. So it was really cool. Like I said, it's called Club Med Sandpiper Bay, Florida. If you guys want to check it out. Look at this rib cheek. Meanwhile, I'm freezing my ass off up here. Yeah. Sorry.
Sorry.
Sorry about that. I know I actually have sleeves on today because it's a little chilly here.
I agree.
So, okay, it's Hanukkah, so happy Hanukkah.
Happy Hanukkah, everyone.
This would be day two, so you get your second present today. I'm not getting any presents, but...
I'm not getting any presents either.
But Cyber Monday.
Jeff Ames is watching.
Oh, cool. So, Cyber Monday. Hi, Jeff Ames, up in Mississippi. So... Okay, Cyber Monday. Today, you can get your booze bandage for cheap.
Ooh!
Super, super cheap. They're having a booze bandage sale today online, boozebandage.com. And you guys, it really does work. So go on to boozebandage.com and check out their great sales. They also have brand new swags. You can get shirts, tanks, t-shirts, all sorts of cool stuff to, you know, be cool, I guess, right?
Yeah.
So, okay. I feel like absolute so full of food that I'm just like, ugh, I don't want to eat or drink anything, you know?
So what are you drinking today?
Oh, thanks, Jim, for the shout out. Yeah, Jeffy, in the house. I have a little beer just because why not?
Why not?
But I thought the most perfect topic for today would be digestifs.
Ooh, that's a good one.
So there's aperitifs and digestifs.
Yep.
And not a lot of people know the difference, so I figured. And, you know, you guys, check this out. Judy showed up with this bad boy, which has got these bottles in it, for my birthday celebration. It's an Aperol Spritz kit. And this is so cool because it's all in this box and it tells you how to make it right down the side. And Aperol Spritzes are all the rage right now. So it's not
all the rage. And the ones that we taste tested in the can, they were no good.
Yeah, there's. I've got a little picture of what a can, if anybody doesn't remember what they look like. But the Aperol, which is the main ingredient in the Aperol Spritz, is a aperitif. And if you're wondering the difference, Jägermeister would be a digestif. Okay, so this is what you're drinking before you eat all that gloppy food, and this is what you're drinking after you eat all that gloppy food. I mean, there's other ones. There's, for instance, Kahlua, Galliano, Sambuca, Amaretto would be different types of digestifs. And we'll start backwards here. This is called a pony glass, and it's a little teeny glass with a little stem.
It's so cute.
When I was little, I didn't know they were for, but you know, you go through your parents' cupboard and you find these little things. And my mom is from Germany, so they used to drink this Jägermeister all the time after they ate. And I never understood why they were drinking that.
Hmm.
You know, the oldest thing in the book is they're talking about this. This is a deer right up in here.
Yeah.
Old wives' tale is this is made with deer blood, but it is not. It is not. So all you do after your big meal, pour yourself a little pony, and you should have Jägermeister cold. It is meant to be cold, okay? And you just nip on it after you eat, and it settles your stomach. This has 56 different herbs and spices in it.
Nice.
So that's what you want to drink after. Or I found this in my liquor cabinet. This is from the 1920s. This is an old, you can't see it. It's creme de menthe.
Ooh.
And this is actually a friend of mine's grandparents. It's green. Grandparents walked around their wedding, after their meal, their wedding, giving this out in little glasses so people could digest.
Okay.
It is a beautiful bottle. It's got to be worth a fortune.
Mm.
So that's your digestive. That's what you're going to drink after you eat. So before is where you want to have an Aperol Spritz. So I thought, let's make one. I've never had one other than the ones in the can that we tried. not good.
But we do know you love champagne.
Oh yeah. This is what it looks like. They've got ones in the bottle too now.
Oh.
So if you want to try it that way. And it's so simple. Take a fancy glass, and it's just equal parts Prosecco. You want to use a nice Italian Prosecco and Aperol. That's all you got to do. Pour it in. We're only going to make a small one, because like I said, I just can't be drinking too much of this stuff today. And I'm not going to use this one because I already have one open up here. So I just happen to have one open.
Imagine that. I said she likes champagne.
So get a nice fresh orange and just drop it in. And that's all it is. Right there. That is your Aperol Spritz. Very, very, very. Oh, and that's good too. I guess I was researching it this morning. If you're walking around the streets of Florence and Italy all afternoon, they're popping these things back all afternoon.
Oh, all the rage in Italy, yes.
They're lower alcohol, lower in your sugar. So it's helping you. And it's good with some salty, like bruschetta or salted nuts.
Yeah.
Whereas your Jäger or your after-dinner drinks are going to be higher in alcohol to help digest all that heavy mashed potato food and everything, you know?
And if we were in Florence and Italy, our digestive choice would probably be the limoncello.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
Yeah. So,
it's so easy. Aperitif before, digestive after.
And then you can just drink all day.
We have an answer for everything around here.
The Italians, they teach you how to drink all day.
Absolutely. And then after you digest, you need to have sweets, right?
Yes.
So remember, God, it had to have been a few months back where we're talking about stars when they all got their booze and everything, and Mariah Carey came out with her Irish liqueur.
Oh, yes.
And she has just partnered with milkstore.com, and they made a Mariah Carey inspired salted caramel cake.
Oh. Okay.
So there's a picture here. Now, the problem is it dropped today at 2 p.m. on milkstore.com. That's it. Dropped at 2 o'clock today. Limited quantities. It's $56. And it's probably already sold out. I'm not sure.
Oh, my goodness.
Now, check this cake out. This Mariah Carey cake is a double chocolate chip cake. That's her licorice or her liqueur that they're inspiring the glaze with this cake with. Okay, so the cake is a double chocolate chip cake with cheesecake, and it's naked, so you can see the different layers.
Oh, my.
It's got cheesecake, coffee, milk, crumbles, caramel frosting. It's 6 inches, serves 12 people, so they say, or, you know, 2 people if you really like it. That's her cake. And it, like I said, milkstore.com today, $56. I tell you, they're all in it. I wish we should have like a Gin Mill Channel cake inspired by us.
Yes, we should.
Speaking of that, you know, there are some people that didn't get all that gloppy feeling. You know why?
Why?
Because they didn't get Thanksgiving dinner. You know why?
Lots of reasons. Tell me yours.
Out in California, there's a Boston market that took like $4,000 of Thanksgiving Day feast orders ahead of time.
Yeah.
And none of their employees showed up to work.
Oh, no.
Big sign on the door. Sorry, no staff. We're not open.
I bet every Chinese food place right around there was slammed.
I'll tell you what. I feel so bad. This one guy said, my meal was $400. I had all these people waiting. I went to pick up my meal, closed down. Because even the GM walked out.
Oh, my goodness.
It's getting worse by the day.
Yeah, it's crazy. Be nice to your servers and bartenders out there, guys. They're working hard.
And now they've got this stupid new variant, Omicron. How do you say it? Do you know how to say it?
No.
I think it's Omicron. I don't know if that's right or not. But now, you know, they interrupted Regis and Kelly this morning with the news press conference. Ugh. So now here we go again.
Yep.
But, oh, it's okay. Like I said, 26 days till Christmas, and I always try to find one super cool gift, and this is for your bartender or amateur bartender friend who loves cats. Check this out. This is a kitty cat bar shaker.
Oh, my.
How cute is that?
And adorable.
It's so cute. And this is westelm.com. So West Elm, like Elm Street. So westelm.com. You can find that kitty cat shaker, and it's 14 karat gold, and it's not expensive. I think it's like $24.50.
There you go.
That's cute. That's something to look at, you know.
It is. Super cute.
You got cakes, kitty cat shakers. The only other thing I found about Canada, you're not going to get any maple syrup because Canada's got a maple syrup shortage. So that's okay. They closed their borders again anyway, so who cares?
Well, there you go.
But, okay, there is one adorable last Advent holiday thing. I keep finding those whiskeys of the Advent calendars, but there is a beer Advent calendar. And this has got all the 12 days of Advent. And you open up a little door, and each one is a sour, one's a lager. It's fabulous. It's a holiday beer box for your beer lover friend. And that's a great gift, too. It's not expensive either. So, anyways, that's about it for today, you guys. We're just kind of getting done with this one holiday. We're getting into the next. We've got so much going on. We've got, I can't even tell you. So make sure you stay tuned. If you are local in St. Lucie County or the Treasure Coast area, Southeast Florida. Don't forget the 12 Pubs of Christmas Holiday Crawl and Toy Drive is going on the 18th of December. And there's only two buses left that aren't full. So what they do is they pile people on the buses and they go all around to different pubs, collect toys for kids in need. But like I said, there's only a few spots left, so make sure you check out the 12 Pubs of Christmas. And it does stop at one of my bars in Gin Mill, so yay. So check that out, and let's just have a great holiday season, because it is here, it's upon us.
Embrace it.
Yes. We want a special, special thanks to our sponsors, Exchange of America, who helped make part of our fun this weekend possible. Thank you so much. Inkhead Graphics, KG Pro Renovations, obviously the Booze Bandage, which keeps us all sober.
Yes.
The Gin Mill, Fort Pierce, and Bogies and Stogies, of course, my two favorite little joints on the coast here. So thank you to everybody for tuning in. And Judy, thank you so much. It was so great to have cocktails with you this weekend. And
yes, yes.
So many more. We have to make it to the, what am I thinking? Delray Beach.
The Death or Glory Bar.
Miracle Pop-Up or the Santa Bar they're doing for a charity, obviously.
Yes, yes. We need to make it down there.
Oh, hi, Jen Lagus. How are you? But yeah, so we'll be doing that. We'll let you guys know if anybody wants to join us. That'll be totally fun. And thank you again so much for everybody tuning in. And happy Hanukkah, season's greetings, Merry Christmas early, and cheers.
Cheers, guys. Thank you.